Good morning. This is MUSAU, Matt Meacham Jr., signing in on Earth. I'm going to have to learn all my ways of greeting my listening audience. I see that in my last three broadcasts, it seemed like I've had a pretty nice attendance. It was quite encouraging that there are people out there in different parts of the world, different ethnic groups, just human beings out there in the world who actually tune in on my broadcast. Now, I think that it may have something to do with my books. And I've decided that I would just use this term when I'm doing my YouTube set. I'll talk about my books. So I have, that means I got a lot. I have, that way I know I can talk about things because I have a lot of books. And what I'll do is this, you're probably not having, I don't think there's another YouTube station like the one I'm getting ready to give you, because I'm going to read to you passages from my books. And I have a half a thousand books published. Yes, I do. Poetry, drama, linguistics, children. I have written things in some of my books. I have special portions that I have a series called Musau Corner. That book called Musau Corner is especially written for young people. I write up short stories, but then I also have part things in there which would be good for young people. Now, I deal with many languages. I've always had an interest in languages. So in my Musau Corner series, it's probably good for the young people. I deal with, I guess, maybe about 10 different languages that include Russian, French, Portuguese, Arabic, Hindi, Arabic. I deal, and if you browse through my book called Musau Corner, I have about 20 volumes. Yes. I have maybe about 20 volumes under that title called Musau Corner. I may have titles, but even in my novels, I have volumes. You know, like for instance, I have a novel series called Jake, but it's in several volumes. I forget how many volumes, maybe 10 volumes, 10 different volumes on the same subject. So I have a lot of material to draw on, hoping that I would be able to entertain my audience. When I turned my computer on this morning, I see that they're still raising Cain in the U.S. at all the different universities. You know, it's really something. These young people who are taking over the universities in the U.S., don't leadership realize that these are your future leaders? Hey, these students, they're not just ordinary. Okay, they're just not ordinary students. These are students at major universities. Berkeley, I mean, these are like really heavy universities. Harvard, Columbia. These universities that these students are raising came at the elite universities. And then you have these policemen dragging them off campus. The policemen dragging the professors. The policemen go on campus and they drive, they drag them, they slap, they beat professors up and the teachers and drag them off. That's what's happening in my homeland, America. That's a shame. It's going to get worse. It's going to get worse. I mean, you guys, you know who you are. You guys, you pharaohs. Yeah, I think the pharaohs, it's like a game for them. They have nothing else to do. The pharaohs, they're bored. These pharaohs are bored people. And so they get their excitements and orgasms when they see these type of things happen to the human population. But that's life. So be it. Blessed be the name of the Lord. What I'm getting ready to do now is read portions of my book, The War Has Begun. And by the way, the books that I'm reading, of course, they're not legally copywritten, but this is witness. This is my witness that I am the originator of the material. I'm on film. It's recorded. It's recorded for present day and for future day. So when I complete these three books, you know, of course, I will go through the procedure of copyrighting all my material. But I know that by my reading my material, I have proof that this is my material. So that's my copyright. That's my personal copyright. And I copyright in several countries. So let me get to back to my book. The War Has Begun. Joel Garvey became a hunted fugitive, not because he was guilty of any crime, but because he was aware of a certain truth which others wanted to hoard and use for their own selfish ends. It was not important that he was the originator. It was important that he was the possessor. And he possessed a knowledge which only others coveted. Human beings make law based on human sentiment, not human virtue. Many times, the virtuous ones perish only because of their decency. The Martian stood up and he felt that it was his turn to say something. The Martian stood up and he felt that it was his turn to say something. He said, "It is how things should be. But why did you take them away?" Joel Garvey cried out, "The Martians had taken all the children." Okay, I've already read that. Let me go down a little bit further. Here's one. Oh, here's a good one. This is chapter one. And in fact, I'm looking at page two. Page two. Look at this. They were angry on Earth. The black folks were getting ready to take over. And the Martians knew that this was the best time to make a major invasion. The Great War came. Blacks against the whites. The Martians were watching them. But the white folks had another trick in their bag. The virus. The pharmaceuticals had undermined the modern civilizations all over the earth. No longer was the world ruled by edicts of political No longer was the world ruled by edicts of political philosophies. These technical intellectuals had become methodological scientists only interested in pseudoscientific foresee, which would increase their camaraderie. Yes. Those are big words. Okay, that's page 3. All right, here we go again. I'm going further. This is, remember, this, the war has begun. Okay. This radical social implementation aggravated the racial struggle throughout the whole earth. And this led to a racial war on earth. And the Martians were watching them. Now, his journey involved the exploration of the center of the earth. And he could feel himself blowing fire out of his mouth. He had become some kind of dragon. What a dream! He awakened again, but he fell into another slumber. I think I need to do a little editing here, but I'm only reading what I have here. And I plan to have the book completed at least about 6 months. So that's all I'm reading for today. I'm looking at my the war has begun, and the thing is, I always deal with the psychological things. I got this character dreaming, like I had the two characters dreaming in my most current book, the one that I'm trying to publish. It ends up Where Is God? So what I do. I see something here, but I'm not going to read it today. This is MUSAU, Matt Meacham Jr. signing out on Earth.